All right, welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the old fairgrounds in Brampton, Ontario, for the feature game tonight between Canada and the United States of America.
Bienvenue tout le monde. On est à la fairground de Brampton. Et le jeu pour aujourd'hui est Canada et les États-Unis.
Introducing the visiting team.
Introduisons l'équipe visiteur. Canada, at second base, au deuxième but. Number 9, numéro 9, Aspen Searle. At right field, Auchan Plot. Number 2, numéro 2, Tori Charters. At center field, Auchan Soccer. Number 15, numéro 15, Chelsea Jenner. The pitcher, La Lanceuse. Number 44, numéro 4 on 4, Sarah Groenwegen. Designated player, joueuse designée, number 23, numéro 23, Jordan Beck. At first base, au premier but, number 18, numéro 18, Miranda Castiglione. At shortstop, Alale Cruz, number 14, numéro 14, Janet Leon. At left field, au champion, number 6, numéro 6, Holly Spears. At third base, au troisième but, number 19, numéro 19, Emma Entsminger. And catcher, la receiveuse, number 20, numéro 20, Riley Carter.
And the home team, the United States of America.
Introduce l'équipe commerciale, les États-Unis. At center field, au champ centre, number 28, numéro 28, Haley McClenney. Designated player, joueuse designée, number 27, numéro 27, Kelsey Stewart. At shortstop, à la left field, number 26, numéro 26, Sierra Romero. At third base, au troisième but, number 14, numéro 14, Misha Sataraka. At left field, au champ gauche, number 2, numéro 2, Emily Crane. The catcher, la receiveuse, number 24, numéro 24, Jessica Plaza. At first base, au premier but, number 9, numéro 9, Lauren Young. At second base, au deuxième but, number 6, numéro 6, Danica Mercado. At the right field, au champ droit, number 15, numéro 15, Andrea Hawkins. And the pitcher, la lanceuse, number 1, numéro 1, Sheridan Hawkins. And now for the umpires this evening, and now for les umps.
Behind the plate, Poussin.
À l'emplate, Poussin.
At first base,
au premier but,
Ortiz. At second base,
au deuxième but,
Ricky Tarangi. At third base,
au troisième base,
Son Mez.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Brampton, Ontario, site of the 2013 Women's Junior World Championships.
Well, welcome all of the supporters from around the world who've made their travel to Brampton, Ontario for this ISF 2013 World Championships.
On va dire merci de tout le monde qui est ici pour cette tournament de ISF de 2013.
All right, we are ready to go here. Crowd is electric, as you may or may not be able to see. It's a full house here at the old fairgrounds. Crowd is packed in here, tight to the gills. There we go. We get a nice wide shot of the stadium. As you can see, the beer tent out in left field is full. We have the third base side. Lots of American, Canadian supporters and fans of the game of softball in general here. Beautiful venue here in Brampton. If you were with us last night, as Team USA takes the field. They're the home team, but I think Canada might have the advantage of strong supporters here, as we are in a Canadian city. Brampton, a suburb of Toronto. You know, once you get used to not having mountains around, it's actually a pretty nice place. Let's talk about this game. Team Canada, the visitors tonight, coming off a 4-0 win over Puerto Rico earlier in the day. They played at noon. Hard-fought battle. Team Canada still leaving runners on base, not able to cash some of those runners that do get on for them. So we're going to see if that's going to come into play tonight. Team USA actually just finished up. Well, I say just finished up. They had a 3-inning outing against Puerto Rico. It was a bit of a blowout, to say the least. 3 innings, 15 runs for the U.S. team. They put up an 11 spot in the first. So, I mean, this really is kind of the feature
leading
game of the night.
For Canada. Make no baton for Canada.
So we hear
number
the,
nine.
PA announcers.
The second base. Dizzy MP. Aspen Searle.
Aspen Searle been doing a good job for Team Canada so far. She's really been able to set the table for this Canadian offense. One of those people who've been able to get on base fairly often. Just going to check her batting order. Our live stats aren't up yet. Those are provided by Point Streak. Here's the first pitch. Strike one called. On the mound today for Team USA is Sheridan Hawkins. He's the pitcher. He's also the flex player. I mean, she and the designated player cannot play at the same time on offense. As we see strike two, as Searle waves at a pitch away. No balls, two strikes to the hitter. Team USA has been exactly what we've expected so far. Strong squad comprised of lots of college freshmen. Well, they would have finished up their freshman year, so. And lots of top 25 students. Top 25 student athletes, sorry. Searle strikes out there.
Batting second.
They've definitely
Number
played a strong
two,
game up to
the
this
right
point.
Fielder.
Kind of odd. You see three lefties pitching for him.
What?
Canadian club matches up well. It's got a number of right-handed hitters. Torrey Charter is one of the few lefties in there. And we saw some explosive base running from Torrey Charters in the earlier game today. Really, her goal went up at the plate there is just to put the ball in play and leg out a base hit as best she can. And she can fly. She takes strike one there. Charters playing right field tonight. Looks like Sheridan Hawkins is really spinning the ball well for the Americans so far. See that tight spiral on it from my vantage point indicates that she's spinning kind of up and under the ball. We're getting a bit of a rising action on that. Of course, physicists will tell you there's no true rise ball, but they haven't stood in there to face one, so. Charter swings under that, strike three. So far, two up, two down for Sheridan Hawkins.
Third, number 15, the center fielder. Middle battle, the middle pace, Sean Saunter, Chelsea Jenner.
We have Chelsea Jenner here. She's from Abbotsford, British Columbia. Steps in here to hit. Thus far in the tournament, she's hitting 636, scorching the ball. She takes ball one outside, laying off that spinner from Hawkins. Definitely some nervous anticipation here in the crowd. The electricity's died off a little bit. I think they're waiting for Team Canada to get some runners on base here. Charter slaps that ball. Ooh, called out on a close play by that first base umpire there. That really could have gone either way, folks. And the Brampton crowd voices their displeasure. So that's getting the crowd into it. Getting the American team into it.
of the 2013 ISF Junior Women's World Championships would like to thank the Government of Canada through Heritage Canada and Sport Canada for their support of this championship.
Le comité organisateur du championnat du monde junior féminin de la ISF de 2013 aimerait remercier le gouvernement du Canada par l'entremise de Patrimoine Canada et Sport Canada pour le soutien de ce championnat.
Team Canada takes the field for the first time. We have
just to let
Sir
the supporters
Ron
know
Wagon
some of the
on
games
the hill
for today. Field Fletcher, Japan over Brazil 8-2. China over Singapore 10-1. New Zealand over Czech Republic 3-1. Canada over Puerto Rico 4-0. Australia over Mexico 5-3. Netherlands over Botswana 7-2. Great Britain 3-2 over Czech Republic. Brazil 6-0 over Singapore. Japan 15, Botswana 0. United States 15, Puerto Rico 0. New Zealand 7, Korea 0. And tonight's feature game, after a half inning of play, it's Canada 0, United States coming to bat.
Enthusiastic Huey on the microphone tonight up here in the public announce. He's having a good time.
0-0.
So leading off for team.
Leading off for the United States, number 28, the center fielder.
Leading off for Team USA is Haley McClenny. She's the center fielder. We're number 28.
Haley McClenny.
McClenny, a native of Morris, Alabama. Alabama, where she plays her college ball. The Groenwagon delivers high for ball one. It's Morris, Alabama. Any place I've never been. Sure it's hard and stink down there, though. McClenny digs in. Here's the pitch. Looks like Groenwagon's spinning the ball well herself. That ball looks to be moving quite well. Riley Carter behind the dish, comprises the other half of the battery. She's also the flex player. She's not hitting tonight. 1-1 the count. Here's a delivery from Groenwagon. Pulls the string for a called second strike as she works ahead in the count to Haley McClenny. Payoff pitch, McClenny waves at it, strike three. Team Canada has it around.
Batting now, number 27, the DP, Kelsey Stewart.
Bringing up Kelsey Stewart, second baseman from Wichita, Kansas. Plays her college ball down in Florida. Appeal down to third base, she went around, strike one. Seems like pretty much the entire U.S. squad is comprised of university players, all playing in the NCAA, several from big schools like Michigan, UCLA, Florida, Oregon, Stanford has a good program, Texas. It's kind of an embarrassment of riches for the U.S. when it comes to women's softball, that's for sure. Which is why they won three, or, you know, did win three or four Olympic gold medals and came second to Japan in the last Olympic Games before softball was so cruelly taken out of the Olympics after the 2008 Games. Fouled away. Kelsey Stewart stays alive here. Two strikes, no balls to the batter. Groenwagon looks like she is a tough nut to crack so far early on in this game. Wind looks to be blowing from kind of east to west here. You see those flags flapping in the wind. Groenwagon pulls the string for strikeout number two.
Batting now, number 26, the shortstop.
Maintenant, bâton, numéro 26, l'arrêt court.
Sierra Romero.
Sierra Romero, hailing from Murrieta, California. She's a Michigan freshman. Just finished up her freshman year. She rips that ball down the line, just a bit foul. Really is a beautiful night here in Brampton. There was supposed to be thunder showers on the horizon. Strong Wagon delivers. That ball's a little high, swung through by Sierra Romero. But as you can see, it's a little hazy, but definitely warm. It's been humid today as well. Hot day here in Brampton, as the SportsCanada.tv crew can attest. That ball's hit in the foul territory. Oh no, fair territory. Beautiful running catch made by Tori Charters as she comes in a long way for that one. Slides onto her hip. That's the third out. So it's going to be almost identical.
Special thanks score to the city of Brampton for their support of this
U.S. team and the Canada team. Two strikeouts. Ground out for the Americans on defense. Canadians in the inning with a pop out to shallow right. So far, no hits to speak of.
After one full inning of play, it's Canada 0, United States 0.
Après une manche, ça c'est le Canada 0 et les États-Unis 0.
Canada. Number 44.
Numéro 44.
The pitcher.
La lanceuse.
Sarah Groenwegen.
So Groenwegen, the cleanup hitter here for Team Canada, starting us off in the top half of the second inning. Batting stats. She's hitting 333. Had some key at-bats yesterday for Team Canada in the feature game. She drove in a couple of runs. She's got five RBI. She hit a home run in the game before that. Ball that got out of, well, I guess Fairgrounds Park number one in a hurry. Might have spilled a couple beers down there in the beer tent. She lines that one foul just a little late on that pitch. Groenwegen from Surrey, British Columbia. Surrey definitely a softball hotbed. As well as a hotbed for many other activities. Here's a pitch from Hawkins to Groenwegen. That ball's inside. Count goes to 2-1. See a lot of national pride in the stands, lots of Canadian flags. A few American flags as well. Heard a lot of very distinctive American accents over there during the Puerto Rican game. Just misses on the outside corner. Looked like a low rise there from Hawkins. Takes a count to 3-1. Looks like the wind's starting to blow in as Groenwegen pops that ball up to first base. And that ball is caught by Lauren Young, playing first for Team USA today, wearing number 9. Brings
batting
up
now,
Jordan
number 23.
Benoit Baton, numéro 23.
The DP.
Joueur désigné.
Jordan Beck.
Beck hails from Vancouver, BC. So 4-5 out of the order there, and hailing from the west coast of Canada. Strike one thrown to Beck. Vancouver's a beautiful town this time of year, not too ostentatious. I prefer it in the spring though, you know, you get some of those cherry blossoms blooming. Man, it's pretty. Beck grounds that one softly to third. Plays made over there to Young by the third baseman, Misha Satakara. Second out of the inning.
That'll bring up number 18. Then I'll bat home and they'll give the lead to first base of Premier View, Miranda Castiglione.
Castiglione, the local girl from Brampton. She swings underneath that pitch from Hawkins. Castiglione has had a solid tournament so far offensively for Team Canada. Sprayed a few hits around last game. So far hitting .455 for the tournament. She's got three runs batted in. Strike two called there. So no balls, two strikes. Two gone here in the top half of the second inning. Looks like we have found a sign out there in center field. We have to get our camera operator Kat to check that one out here between innings. Castiglione stands in, takes a ball in the outer half. I don't know if Hawkins was upset with that call. It's definitely a close pitch. One and two to count. Hawkins looks in for the sign. Gets the one she wants. Here's the pitch. Strike three. That rise ball is working well this evening. As we hear chants of USA, USA. Oh, here we go. Canadian fans trying to drown out their American counterparts. Doesn't take long for them to do that. Kat, can we get a shot of that? So it's not up there anymore. There was a sign out in center field. I was kind of wondering what it said. It's not up
softball
there anymore.
Softball fans, we're honored to have with us this evening the Minister of Sport for the Government of Canada, the Honorable Val Gasol, who is seated behind home plate.
And if you softball, you coming for the Minister of Sport, the Government of Canada, Honorable Val Gasol.
Apparently we have some dignitaries in the house tonight, ladies and gentlemen.
Support women's softball in our quest to play in the 2020 Olympic Games. Visit www.playball2020.com.
Appuyez le softball féminin dans notre quête de jouer aux Jeux Olympiques de 2020. Visitez www.playball2020.com.
We also have a couple of Ontario's finest up here in the booth with us. Peel Regional Police, making sure everything's on the up and up here.
Leading off for the United States.
Hopefully nobody steals any bases.
Number 14. The third base.
Just got a high five from the producer, Jillian, there.
Misha Satakara.
Unfortunately, we don't have a camera up here in the booth to see what kind of shenanigans we get up to. Misha Satakara playing third base for Team USA. She stands in using an Easton bat. I've always found Easton to be a very agreeable product. Strike one called. Dronewagen pulls the string on that one. Looks like Misha Satakara clenched up on that pitch. Locked the legs when she saw that off-speed ball. Couldn't uncoil. Nice rise ball in the inner half there from Dronewagen. She's quickly up. No balls, two strikes. This Canadian pitcher seems, she seems sure to match her American counterpart this evening thus far. Good pitch, paints the outer half, doesn't get the call. One ball, two strikes. Misha Sadakara, native of Honolulu, Hawaii. As she swings through, strike three. She takes her place on the bench next to her fallen comrades.
Number two.
And all back home in the middle there.
The left fielder.
Or sharp coach.
Emily Crane.
Emily Crane from Troy, Missouri. You know what? She's sticking close to home too, playing her college ball at Missouri. Here's the pitcher from Groenwagen. Ball one, looks a little high. Crane, a diminutive player, one of the smaller ones in this U.S. team. What always strikes me at these events, or at least at the last one in Whitehorse, the Women's World Championships, and this one as well, is, you know, just how tall some of the American pitchers are. These ladies are built, well, for lack of a better word, they're well built. You know, Jordan Taylor comes to mind, standard about 6'1". But Kalani Ricketts, who's, she had to be close to 6 feet, 6'1". The senior women's team is at rise balls high. Two balls, one strike. Not sure if our boy Steven's watching from Whitehorse last year. Strike two's thrown there. Crane whips through. Steve was, well, I guess he was an attaché with the American team. We made friends with him up in the broadcast booth, had a good time. Steve, we miss you. He's a good guy. I hope he's watching. If not, I hope maybe one of you American viewers out there tonight is you know, knows Steve. Just tell him he gave him a shout out. Tell him Adam and the girl say hi. In case I forgot to mention, I'm Adam Donnelly here with SportsCanada.tv. I'm the voice of softball on SportsCanada.tv. We're here in Brampton, Ontario for the Women's Junior World Championship. It's under 19, folks. Feature game of the evening. Team USA taking on Team Canada. USA won the coin toss. They're the home squad. We have a full count here with 1-0 to Ellie Crane. That ball's popped up into foul territory. Just out of play. Okay, Emma Ensminger, third base for Team Canada, just couldn't get to that ball. That ball slapped right to Ensminger. She makes a fantastic play. Little bunny hop to pick that ball up. Two gone here, bottom half of the second inning.
That'll bring up number 24.
Ain't no bad throw in the middle of the cap.
The catcher.
The high team base.
Jessica Plaza.
Jessica Plaza coming up here. Huntington Beach, California. She is a student at Stanford. Student athlete, I should say. That changeup's in the dirt. Ball one from Groenwagen. There's definitely a number of Canadian ladies who have some NCAA experience or will get some in the near future. I know that ball stroked down the left field line. Just foul. It was out of play, it was a ways foul. Just trying to over-dramatize things. Kids, please, don't abscond with the balls. We need to keep the balls intact. I know several balls have been absconded with, and I think they were getting a little short on them. A little short on balls here. Swung on, strike two. Strike three, a throw down to first base to Beck. And that's three outs, folks. So Groenwagen sets him down in order. folks, it's official. Two scoreless innings. I think we have a pitcher's duel on our hands. Not sure about you, but in my books, two scoreless with no hits always means a pitcher's duel.
Just want to let all of the supporters know refreshments are all around the park. We have the beer tent behind left field, food out in center field, and also down the first and third base lines.
Join us tomorrow on SportsCanada.tv. We're going to be broadcasting all day live here from the park in Brampton. We're also going to have the feature game. It's going to be Canada versus New Zealand. And sounds like I might have a little company in the booth for that one. Won't be so lonely up here. Might have a nice Kiwi gentleman coming up and having a little chat. We'll be flapping the gums. You can reach us on Twitter. Our handle, at SportsCanadaTV. Let us know if you like the broadcast.
Canada coming to bat in the top of the third inning.
We're always happy to have a little feedback from you.
Just
remember, we're people too. And our moms don't like reading negative feedback on Twitter.
Number 14.
So if you got something negative to say, keep it to yourself or send us an email.
The shortstop. Janet Leung.
Janet Leung coming up here for Team Canada. As we're into the 789 club here. Third inning. Getting to the bottom of the order. Seeing if this bottom of the rack can't turn it over for the top half here. She fouls that ball away. A little tardy on that swing. One strike to Leung. You know, Leung's had a solid tournament so far at shortstop for Team Canada. I don't think she's made any errors that I can think of. Don't quote me on that. I'm not consulting our live stats program on that. She has definitely been hitting the ball well in the past couple games. Smacked a home run last evening. Canada beat up on... Who did they play last night? Yeah. Korea, that's right. They beat up on Korea pretty good. 11-1's the final. That ball's foul tipped just out of the catcher's mitt. Count remains one ball, two strikes. But you can hear some of that crowd noise. This place is literally packed about as tight as you can. It's cheek to jowl up in the stands there. We had a boisterous match last game. The Kiwi supporters, I'd have to put them, some of the best fans in the crowd, were out there cheering on their team as they beat the Koreans again. Those poor Koreans are just getting lumped up. Maybe Korea 7-0 in six innings. Total team effort, really well pitched game by the Kiwi thrower. Which is good, you know, I was a little disappointed last year for a couple reasons in the Kiwi squad. One, they didn't play as well as I'd hoped. Leung pops out to second base. And two, the women didn't dance the haka, which, you know, it's all been fixed here. The ladies have been playing some great ball.
That'll
little blip against the British national team yesterday.
The left fielder.
They've come back strong.
I
believe they're 4-1 now. Not sure if they've had their bye game against Venezuela, who unfortunately couldn't show up due to some unfortunate visa reasons. So all the Venezuelan games have been forfeits up to this point. So, up now we have Holly Spears. She's playing left field. She tattooed a home run earlier today in Canada's win over Puerto Rico. Here's the pitch. Change up from Hawkins. And Lauren Young took that one herself.
That'll bring up number 19.
Score that one, 3 unassisted.
Making all back on the mail, decent up.
The third base. Emma Ensminger.
That brings us to the number 9 hitter in the Canadian order, Emma Ensminger. Just a bit of alliteration for you. Emma hoping she can spark this Canadian offense. She takes strike 1. Hawkins has been working that rise ball to perfection. She's throwing it up, she's throwing it down. You know, it's a little different of a look coming from a lefty. Although Canada is employing a lot of right-handed bats in their lineup tonight to try and counter the left-handed pitching. The ball just tends to move opposite. You know, the majority of pitchers are going to be right-handed, although I guess you do see some lefties. It's always a bit of an adjustment, as it has been tonight for Team Canada. Ensminger, no balls, two strikes. Looks like Hawkins tried to take a little bit off of that. That's ball one. Bit of a waste pitch there. Here's the pitch. Oh, foul tip juggled a little bit back there. Jessica Plaza just couldn't hold on to it. It's okay, keep Sensminger alive here. Here's the pitch. Sensminger hangs in there. Count stays at one ball, two strikes. Two down here in the top half of the third inning for Team Canada. Ensminger trying to turn the order over for Aspen Searle. Canada hoping they can get a little something going second time through this lineup. That one in the dirt, blocked well by Jessica Plaza. Evens the count, two balls, two strikes, two gone. We really have to give the province of Ontario and the city of Brampton, the Flower City as they call it, credit for putting on such a fantastic tournament in such a beautiful venue. We're surrounded by trees, green space. Count run full there by Ensminger. So I was saying, you know, it's really an ideal setting for a tournament such as this. Really a great way to see some of the country. I know I've been to Whitehorse for an ISF event last year. Now a trip to Brampton. That ball's popped high, looking into foul territory. Second baseman calls off the first base, and we're out of the inning. Canada goes down in order yet again. Through two and a half innings, we're scoreless here in Brampton, Ontario.
Check out that USA chant again. New website, www.softball.ca, for news and program and information.
Yeah, you have to give the U.S. fans credit. They're kind of setting the tone for the Canadians here. Canadians a little unsure what to do in a situation like this. By now their team would have scored at least one or two runs.
Canada nil, United States nil.
Canada kind of a reactionary patriotism being shown here.
Canada 0, les États-Unis 0.
The wind's blowing out now. Here we go. A little creativity from the Canadians. Calling on the heritage of maybe the Commonwealth there.
Leading off in the bottom of the third inning for the United States.
One of the best parts about coming to events like this is seeing teams from far-flung reaches of the earth, Brazil. You know, there's definitely a lot of rhythm in their game. Botswana as well. I mean, you can't beat the singing that squad does. Beautiful pitch there by Groenwagen to start off the 7-8-9 hitters here in the American lineup. The American lineup is certainly not a traditional lineup with the 789, that's very much. 789 hitters being weak. As I mentioned earlier, these girls, all veterans of top flight NCAA programs. And these really are the best of the best and probably also picked for their ability to play the team game. We have our first hit of the game, folks. That's the old Lauren Young, the first baseman for Team USA. She singles one up the middle, past the shortstop.
Making all bat on the middle seats.
The second base.
The DZMB.
Danica Mercado.
Brings up Danica Mercado, second base for Team USA. Mercado, California native, from Temecula. She plays at Oregon. Teammate of Sheridan Hawkins at Oregon University. A couple of Ducks. Lauren Young from Anaheim, California. She plays at Arizona. Jenny Finch's alma mater, if I remember correctly. I believe the tournament got a bit of a Twitter shout out from Jenny Finch the other day. Always a class act. She played in this event back in 99, I believe. Just the start of an illustrious international career for that lady. Heck of a pitcher, heck of a ball player, class act all around. That ball just misses. Takes the count to 1-2 here with one on. That ball's hit up the middle. Two singles in a row for Team USA. The runner holds at second base, Lauren Young there. So Danica Mercado, she has a single. You start to see these American bats start to wake up, you know. This is kind of where you'd expect a super strong American program to kind of pull away. Bringing up Andrea Hawkins, the right fielder. Andrea Hawkins, no relation to Sheridan. She's from Bay City, Texas. She plays at Alabama. And as a lefty, it looks like she's trying to employ a little run and gun, a little slap bunt. She comes dancing out of the box there. And just watch it. There's a pretty defined technique here. You can't really see her feet. She takes a couple of steps before she attempts at the ball there. I mean, it's almost as if she's halfway down the line before she attempts at that ball. It's a technique definitely widely employed by the Japanese and a lot of other Asian teams. You know, it's an advantage that a left-handed hitter has. They're automatically 4 to 5 feet closer. She kind of slaps at that one, foul out of play. Takes a count to 1-2. Goldwagon looking for an out here. This is a big at bat as the order's about to get turned over. We're about to get back into the strength of the U.S. order. Haley McClenny, the center fielder on deck. Here's the pitch from Groenwagon. Half-hearted attempt made there. Let's see the appeal. Third base umpire rules. She didn't go. Evens the count at 2-2. Nobody out here in the bottom half of the third inning. Groenwagon toes up that rubber. Runners get their leads. Nice pitch as she pulls the string. Strikes out the number 9 hitter, gets a very big out. But she's not out of the fire yet. That brings up Haley McClenny.
And no, that's on the middle. Van Wheat,
the center fielder.
Or Sean Saunter.
Haley McClenny.
So you can hear PA announcers there. They're starting to get into a rhythm. Good teamwork there. Of course, we have both official languages of Canada, French and English. Very nice pitch there. That moves from left to right, just over the back half of the plate there from Groenwagon. Strike one. Clank stands in. We have a runner in scoring position. One away. She slaps that ball the other way. Just foul onto the outfield grass. That could have been trouble for the Canadian squad. They're playing this American lineup fairly deep out there. Left fielder Holly Spears, probably only about 4 or 5 steps off the warning track, so plenty of respect for the power that this American squad possesses. Nice rise ball from Growing Wagon for show. 1-2. Haley McClenney trying to cash these two runners that Team USA got on. Lauren Young led off the inning with a single. Danica Mercado followed up with a single of her own. So you see the first real threat from Team USA offensively this evening. Gornwagon pitches. And that's a base hit. Misplayed out there by Spears. And it looks like we might have 2 runs here. Cut off his hit, Leung holds the ball. So the leadoff hitter, Haley McClenney, draws first blood for Team USA as those 2 singles come back to hurt. A little misplay out in left field allows those runs to score. It would have been a lot closer, and that second run probably wouldn't have scored if Spears could have made that play out in the field. All part of the learning process for these young ladies as they try to improve their game and work their way up to the national program. Bunt shown there from Kelsey Stewart, the designated player wearing number 27 this evening. Stewart's 0-1 with a strikeout. That ball's in the dirt. Aggressive jump from McClenney there. She holds the second base. Good job of blocking that ball from Canadian catcher Riley Carter. Riley's done a good job of handling the Canadian pitching up to this point. Stewart tried to slap at that one. Just underneath it, just fouled straight back. 2-1 the count, 1 away. The runner in scoring position, Haley McClenney. She just hit a, not sure if it's gonna be roll a double or a single. Single with an error maybe. Great change up there. You know, that's one really effective weapon to use against the kind of that slap drag bunt style of hitting. If you can throw their timing off, it really is all about trying to time that pitch in, time the velocity. One way to do it is try and throw the rise ball and get them to pop it up. Another way, try and obstruct their timing as that ball's popped high. Looks like it'll stay in play, but Spears can't get to it. That was a long run. Would have been a very tough play for Miss Spears to make, Holly Spears. I don't believe there's any relation to Britney Spears. Could be wrong, though. I've been known to be wrong in the past. Once or twice. Nobody's perfect, right? Speaking of nobody's perfect, if you want to give us a little shout out on Twitter, at Sports Canada TV, you tweet us, we're going to give you a shout out on air, folks. My man, Choyle Brown, the CEO, president, he's here working hard behind the scenes. He doesn't want me to mention his name. So that ball scoots away. Team Canada can't get the speedy Haley McClenney as she takes third on a bit of a miscue there. Brings the count full to Kelsey Stewart. 3-2, 1 here. Bottom half of the third inning. One more run, only 60 feet away. That ball's lifted high and deep to left field. Runner tags up. Throw's not going to be in time from Spears, and that's a third American run. So Stewart does her job, gets a sacrifice fly. There are now 2 out, but 3 runs have come across the plate here in the third inning.
That'll bring up number 26.
And back on Sierra there. Romero, the shortstop, coming up. Shortstop.
Alele Cool. Sierra Romero.
Yeah. Looks like we might have our first Twitter shout out of the evening. Uh-oh. That ball is fouled away by Sierra Romero. Looks like Twitter is broken, folks. We got something from John Winger here, at Retire26. Just like to apologize for losing that feed. To be honest, it wasn't much of a ball game, as I think the Puerto Rican team had used up a lot of their horses against the Canadian squad in a close game this afternoon. 50-0 after three. So I'm not sure if we lost the feed or that's just when the game ended, but it was certainly a quick one there. I think it took less than 45 minutes to play that game. So that ball's popped high into center field. Jenner settles under it. Can of corn for her. But the damage has been done. Team USA scores 3 in the third, and Team Canada's in a bit of a hole.
Brampton Girls Softball Association and the organizing committee thank the Trillium Foundation for their support.
Association de softball féminine de Brampton et le comité organisateur remercie la Fédération Trillium pour leur soutien.
After three full innings of play, the United States open up their account and lead 3-0. Canada coming to bat. Leading off for Canada in the top of the fourth inning, number 9.
Maintenant bâton pour le Canada, numéro 9.
The second base.
Au deuxième but,
Aspen Searle.
Aspen Searle steps in as Canada starts their second time through the order. Searle 0-for-1 with a strikeout so far against Hawkins. Searle trying to get this offense started here. Not really much action for Team Canada, no runners. That ball's popped foul, looks like it's out of play. Comes down just to my right. Hope that wasn't somebody's head. Didn't sound like somebody's head, sounded more like aluminum roofing. These days, you never know. Kind of made a kerplunk sound, didn't it? Kind of a kerplunk. Right off the roof. Aspen Searle. I think she's an Ontario native. Aspen Searle from Brantford, Ontario. Beautiful Brantford, Ontario. Sure, it's just down the road from Brampton, although I really have no clue. I know Mississauga's just down the road from Brampton. Vaughan's pretty close. Toronto's not too far.
Brings up number 2.
Richmond Hill somewhere
back
around
on the middle.
The right fielder.
Just listing off suburbs of Toronto that I know.
Tory Charters.
I've also been to Hamilton. Home of the Tiger Cats. The CFL season started up. Probably shouldn't be plugging the CFL because... we certainly don't carry him on our network, but, you know, who can resist some good old-fashioned three-down football? good reason to, you know, pop out a couple of Pilsners. That's the brand, folks. I know any Saskatchewan viewers we have know what I'm talking about. Vitamin P, green champagne, whatever you call it. You know, you carve out a little watermelon, you put it on your head, and watch your riders play. No watermelon hats here, but plenty of Canada regalia. A couple folks are wearing some interesting headgear over to my right. Maybe we can get a shot of that between innings. Here's the pitch from Hawkins. Just misses on the outer half. Tory Charter staying alive. Tory Charter's from Winnipeg, Manitoba, home of the Blue Bombers, speaking of the CFL. Winnipeg is, you know, Winnipeg gets a bad rep. It's a beautiful city. We were actually there with SportsCanada.tv not long ago. I believe it was October. We went there for a national soccer event. And man, it was cold. Ate at Ray and Jerry's. Probably one of the nicest steakhouses I have been to. As Charters goes down swinging. Looks like Hawkins took a little off that one, and there's another strikeout for her. So two out as she just keeps
bring up
on rolling over this Canadian line.
Center fielder, O'Shawn Sunfer, Chelsea Jenner.
Chelsea Jenner steps in. As I mentioned, Jenner has been on fire, en fuego, for this tournament. She was hitting 636 before this game started. Had a ground out in the first inning. Cap off that first inning for Team USA. She did ruin the strikeout party for Hawkins, but they still got her out. She's looking to change that here. Jenner from Abbotsford, BC. It's a quaint little town. But it is home of the Abbotsford International Air Show, which is just a fantastic event. If you ever have the chance and enjoy going to see old aircraft like that, as Jenner takes strike one. Used to go every year. My cousin was in the Canadian Forces Skyhawks jump demonstration team. Bunch of crazy idiots, if you ask me, jumping out of a perfectly good airplane, but definitely was spectacular. As I said, Abbotsford, kind of a far-flung suburb of Vancouver. Definitely in a nice part of the Fraser Valley, though. Picturesque, you can see Mount Baker. Jenner grounds out to first base. And that's it for Canada in the top half of the fourth. Team Canada really is rolling.
Ontario welcomes all the teams and players to this event. Enjoy your stay. The gouvernement de l'Ontario accueille toutes les équipes et les joueurs à cet événement. Profitez de votre séjour. We've got a full stadium. Let's make a little noise. Let's hear it from the fans on the first baseline.
We have our PA announcer, or eccentric.
Let's hear it from the fans on the third baseline.
Trying to pump the crowd up.
And let's hear it from the supporters out in left field. Can we hear you out there in the beer tent?
I don't know that they have any speakers out there in left field, but maybe they're just too engrossed in their cups. We could definitely hear them in here in the broadcast booth. He's having a good time, folks. Just want to give a shout out to the hardworking scorekeepers here, updating all of us on live text. They're doing a heck of a job. We got paper scorekeepers, we got cyber scorekeepers.
Leading off for the United States.
No, two kinds of scorekeepers is pretty good.
Number 14. The third base. Misha Sararaka.
In comes a cleanup hitter for Team USA, Misha Sadaraka. Misha was retired in her first at bat. I believe it was on a strikeout. Misha, she's our Hawaiian native. Honolulu, she laces that ball in the right. Chartis tracks it down easily for the first out. That ball was struck well.
Batting now, number two.
Ain't no bad phone, the manager.
The left fielder.
Ochampos.
Emily Crane.
Misha, playing on the west coast of of California. She's a UCLA freshman with them this year. Looks good in the blue and gold. I'm not quite sure those are the colors. I think Michigan's definitely blue and gold. Yeah. Not sure what you'd call that. Maybe a baby blue, powder blue. What, like a periwinkle? Just talking with my producer, Jillian, over here. We can't really decide on a name for the color. But you know what? I think those UCLA unis look real good. And I mean, UCLA, Los Angeles, definitely a beautiful part of the United States. SoCal, you can't beat it. Then again, you can't beat Brampton. Not right now. Wind's blowing through the broadcast booth. It's starting to cool off a little bit here after a hot, muggy day. That ball's hit hard to the shortstop. Good quick throw over. Gets Emily Crane, speedy Emily Crane.
That'll bring up sure number 24.
Know about Tony, no,
the catcher.
Aspen Searle, that's not Aspen Searle. That's Janelle Young. Plaza. Heck of a play there to get her. It's the second out of the inning, bringing up Jessica Plaza. Catcher for Team USA, wearing number 24. She takes strike one on the outer half. You know, all the experience, all the practice that these US players get, it definitely shows. Such an advantage to have this wealth of talent. She fouls that one off her leg. And the NCAA just shows us why it's allowed the U.S. to be in the position it has in women's softball for the years. It just does such an unparalleled job of developing players. There really is no development system like it. And, you know, you start to see some players from other countries, Canada especially. I know there's some Dutch players who played there. Definitely some sort of Puerto Rican players have taken advantage of the NCAA route. And it's really up the level of play of these ladies, and it's fantastic to see. Obviously, Japan does a fantastic job with their national team as Plaza strikes out there. Groenwagen gets out of the inning unscathed. So just the one blemish there. It's a big one, though. 3-0 hole Team Canada's in.
Play softball in 2014. Join the Brampton Girls Softball Association or your local league.
Jouer au softball in 2014. Joignez-vous à l'association de softball féminin de Brampton ou votre ligue locale.
After four full innings of play, it's the United States 3, Canada 0.
Après quatre manches, c'est les États-Unis 3, le Canada 0.
Top of the fifth coming up.
Man, I can really smell. You know what? We have competing flavors here today. I know we probably talked way too much about food and dinner last night. But I know I can really, your call. We really have competing kind of food carts here. We got the popcorn to our right of the broadcast booth, and it's wafting. But you also get kind of, you got the deep fryers going. We have the Beaver Tails truck over here. And let me tell you, the Beaver Tails truck, for those of you not familiar with Canada's national treat, you've maybe heard of poutine, and that's not a treat. They're serving poutine. The Beaver Tail is a long, let me get this right, it's a long flat donut. It's a deep fried pastry.
Now in the top of the fifth inning for Canada.
I think you put some, like some powdered sugar, maybe bananas, like a Nutella type thing.
Number 44,
holy smokes.
The pitcher.
They smell good. I've seen a couple people eating
Sarah
them. They look
Groenwegen.
Hella good. The cheer you hear there is for the Canadian pitcher. Also the number 4 hitter, Sarah Groenwegen. You know, it's rare in international softball you see a pitcher hitting, let alone in the 4 spot. So that definitely says something about Sarah Groenwegen and the faith that the coaching staff has in her as a just a player in general. And there we go, Denise. Sorry, our event organizer, Denise. Looks, is that a beaver tail? It's not? Oh, it's a Panzerotti. Okay. I thought we had a beaver tail sighting. Turns out it's an Italian delicacy. Sorry for the false alarm there, folks. Just drone wagon takes ball 2. I was trying to get her take on the beaver tail experience, because I've never had one myself. But as I said, it truly is a unique Canadian treat. Here's the pitch. That one just misses the outside corner. Runs a count to 3 balls, no strikes. And our executive producer and director of events here, also operating camera, Kat Britton, is kind of mocking me a little bit, it seems like. I'm okay with that. Groenwegen cutting loose on that 3-0 count. Must have got the green light from the coaching staff. She absolutely uncoiled at that ball. Fortunately, Hawkins is just throwing BBs tonight, folks. Absolutely spinning a gem. Here's a pitch. Groenwegen tardy on that. First baseman Young. I'm going to get these names
down. That brings up number
Lauren
23.
Young. Tags her base for an unassisted
put-up. The designated player, joueuse designée, Jordan Beck.
Brings up Jordan Beck with one away. Beck hitting in the 5 spot tonight for Team Canada. Canadian team hoping she can get something going for him here. Back to DP, she's hitting for, I think, the catcher tonight, actually, Riley Carter. So far in this tournament, Beck maybe not hitting as well as the coaching staff had hoped. Putting up a 200 average. She's drawn 1 walk, scored 2 runs, though. Does have a double. Her only hit of the tournament, actually, is a double. So she's 1 for 5 so far. She's in a hole here, 2 strikes. Wines, here's the pitch. Beck was out in front of that one. She reached for it, managed to pop it out of play, straight back. Went over top of our broadcast booth here. Sorry about that, I'm smacking the mic with my papers here. I want to be doing that. Big one's main ball. Beck goes down swinging, strike 3. 2 out here for 2.
Brings up number 18. Maintenant, bâton numéro 18, the first base of premier but, Miranda Castiglione.
Miranda Castiglione. As you can hear a rousing cheer from here, she is a local girl. Brampton's very own Miranda Castiglione. She stands in there for the second time. Takes a ball in the inner half. Not sure Hawkins agreed with that call. I think the home plate umpire is doing a heck of a job here tonight, though. The whole blue crew really has been solid for this tournament so far. No complaints. Seen a bit of controversy, but nothing out of the ordinary at a tournament like this. So that ball's popped to the Jordan Young, first baseman. She handles that easily. Canada goes down in order again. And I'm not...
After 4.5 innings of play, it's the United States 3, Canada 0. The fans are going to get treated for a bottom of the fifth. Take me out to the ball game. Take me out to the ball game. Take me out to the crowd. Buy me some peanuts and Cracker Jacks. I don't care if I ever get back, cause it's root, root, root for the home team. If they don't win, it's a shame, cause it's root, two, three strikes, you're out at the old ball game. Make a little noise.
A rousing version of Take Me Out to the Ball Game for our PA announcer. The young fella's got to do it in French now. Not sure if we'll have that. One of the beauties of this tournament, of course, Canada being a bilingual country, getting our announcements in both English and French. We're right next door to Quebec. Actually got a nice little shout out
leading
last
off
night
for the United States in the bottom of the fifth
Quebec
inning.
You know, since nobody's tweeting us today, at least that
number
I know.
Number nine, you made enough. The first base, en premier but, Lauren Young.
I'm going to go out and give another shout out to Softball Quebec for the lovely Twitter shout out they gave us for the broadcast. Hopefully they're watching again tonight as Team Canada goes to work. Lauren Young now. She is from Anaheim, California. Anaheim, home of Disneyland. I mean, who can beat Disneyland? It's a heck of a lot of fun. From what I remember, maybe not the prettiest city in the world, but I had a good time there. Of course, I was 9 years old and I was at Disneyland, so who doesn't have a good time, right? I believe we stayed at the Penny Saver Inn. Not too far from the park, walking distance. I think I went on Splash Mountain about 5 times. Certainly the best spring break I've ever been on. Growing Wagon goes to work here in the bottom half of the fifth. 2-1 to the batter. Young plays at Arizona, as I mentioned before. She swings through that one. My correction, you know what, I don't think it's Lauren Young. Yeah, it is. It is. I'm right. Shouldn't be second guessing myself. Young actually started the offensive onslaught for Team USA back in the third. She hopes to get something going again. Looks like Growing Wagon wants to stay away from her here. She's thrown a couple pitches outside. That counts run to full. 3-2. Nobody gone here in the bottom half of the fifth inning. A little action in the Canadian pen over there. That's number 11, Alex Segal. As Young strikes out, another K for Growing Wagon. She's had a
that
solid
up
game
six
on the hill.
May know about on the male seat. The second base of Busy MB, Danica Mercado.
Danica Mercado from Temecula, California. Can't say I've ever been to Temecula. Nice little pop out there. Real efficient as Aspen Searle handles that one.
Batting now.
Two gone
number
here.
Number 15.
Bottom half of the fifth.
No baton. The middle paint. The right fielder. Oshamquat. Andrea Hawkins.
Andrea Hawkins. Freshman in Alabama. From Bay City, Texas. Sure, another barbecue mecca of the USA. That's really how I know my geography is what foods come from, what regions of the world. She tries to lay down a bunt. That one's slapped foul. Andrea Hawkins stands in with a 1-1 count. Kronwagen winds. Here's the pitch. Oh, nasty hop over Ensminger there, and Hawkins gets the U.S. offense underway here with two out in the bottom half of the fifth. Turns the order over, does exactly what's asked of number 9 here in that situation.
Maintenant, bâton numéro 28, the center field, au champ centre, Haley McClenney.
As I mentioned, you want to give your horses a chance to run. And as a number 9 hitter in that situation, you really just are looking to put the ball in play. And hopefully they'll find a seam, find a hole, you know, drop into the outfield somewhere. And you're going to get something going, turn the order over, and get the dangerous part of the lineup going. Although, like I said, you know, this U.S. team really isn't a traditional softball lineup. Maybe it's traditional for them because they are dangerous, 1-9. Here's the pitch from Kronwagen. That ball's hit high into the air out in right field. Spears goes back, makes the catch. That's 3 outs. So any more damage is averted there. Team Canada holds the U.S. to the existing 2-0 lead.
After 5 full innings of play, it's the United States 3, Canada 0. Après 5 matchs, c'est les États-Unis 3, le Canada 0.
There we go. I see a beautiful
top of the sixth coming up.
Stands there.
Maintenant, le sixth match.
Certainly, it doesn't look healthy. Man, baton. It looks delicious. It's just a big old donut.
Like to get those fans and supporters making a little noise on the first base side. And can I hear a little noise from the fans on the third baseline? And can I hear it from both the first base and third base side? Make a little noise. We got a ball game here. Leading off for Canada, number 14.
Maintenant, bâton pour le Canada, numéro 14.
The shortstop.
À la cour,
Janet Leung.
We're here, folks. President of the 789 Club, Janet Leung. Seventh spot here in the Canadian order. She steps in. Looking to spark this Canadian offense. It really hasn't, they haven't seen anything. They have a few pop-ups, few ground balls, but really, they at no point have they been in danger of scoring. They've gone down in order in every inning up to this point. I mean, you really have to give a lot of credit to Hawkins, who's kept them off balance and seems relied solely on a dominant rise ball, mixing in the odd changeup, fastball here and there. What a lot of pitchers, coaches would call a fastball, I probably would consider a peel drop ball. Whatever it is, it's all been working for tonight. That one gets away from her a little. One ball, two strikes to the batter, Leung, the shortstop for Team Canada. Leung fouls that one away to stay alive. I mean, we've seen plenty of scrappiness and determination from those Canadian batters, but you know, when it comes down to the clench, they just haven't been able to do it. Certainly have not gotten the job done here. And that's certainly one of the dangers when you have a team like this Canadian squad who, I mean, they're a very, very strong team, no doubt about it. But at the same time, they're just, you know, maybe not hanging at that same level as Team USA or Team Japan. There's the pitch. That ball's outside. Actually, you know what? I think Team USA won bronze in 2008. I mistakenly said they lost to Japan in the final. I don't think they did. I think they might have been knocked out early in the tournament. I'm just gonna check that on Google, folks. Beauty of technology. Maybe if somebody on Twitter could let me know about that. Here we go. Ah, I was wrong. The U.S. did win silver. That was right all along. Australia winning the bronze there. In fact, that's the exact same order from Whitehorse last year, the 2012 World Championships. We were lucky enough to be a part of. Young hits that ball to shortstop, picked up. And that is smooth like butter, folks.
Brings up number six.
Romero being a superior athlete and making a
the left fielder, Holly Spears.
So one shortstop grounds to the other, which brings up Holly Spears. Ball one to Spears. Spears hitting 400 in the tournament so far, so she's definitely been one of the stronger bats in the Canadian lineup. One ball, one strike, one away here in the top half of the sixth. Getting down to it, Canada down to their last five outs here in the ball game. Unless the U.S. can blow it open in the bottom half of the inning. That ball's taken outside. I'm not sure they'll be able to do that. Sarah Groenwegen has responded well to the three runs she gave up in the bottom of the third. She shut down Team USA from there. She had a little conference to mound. Pfizer maybe didn't like what she saw. Went out and had a little talk with Hawkins. They're on the same page now. Two balls, one strike to the batter. Spears stands in there. Here's the pitch. She waves it a ball away. You know, it seems like these Canadian batters are trying to force it a little late in the game. Maybe not waiting for that ideal pitch. Chasing a little bit as that ball was down and away. Spears waved at it. 2-2 the count. Spears manages to fight off that inside rise ball, get a piece of it just off her hands. Foul it out of play. Just on top of the broadcast booth here. One away here. Spears really trying to get this Canadian offense started. Nobody's been able to do it up to this point. That ball's fouled back to the screen. So, you know, as I've said, these Canadian batters are scrappy, they're resourceful, and they're determined, but so far unable to solve. Miss Hawkins. That ball's low. That runs the count to full anyways. Just looking at the pitch counter here, Hawkins really has been dealing. 54 strikes thrown, 22 balls, 76 pitches. As we're here into the sixth inning, I mean, really an economy of effort. That ball's grounded up the middle. There it is, folks. First hit of the ball game for Team Canada. There goes the no-no. There goes the perfect game. I didn't want to say anything. I'm a superstitious man. I didn't want to jinx it, but Holly Spears has broken the goose egg in the hit column, and with one out here in the sixth inning, Team Canada's in business. We're going to see how that affects Sheridan Hawkins. Looks like we're going to have a pinch hitter here. So 19 in for 21.
Starting now, number 21. May know about Tonga.
Check, we have 21 in for 19.
Lindsay Ogilvie.
Lindsay Ogilvie stepping in for Emma Entsman. Ogilvie takes strike one. That looked like a low spinner. What a frozen Ogilvie.
I think we're going last call for alcohol here, folks. So Olivia has one strike against her, one run runner on. She takes strike two. Hawkins is responding with authority to that hit given up to Molly Spears. Ogilvie in a pretty deep hole here, especially for someone who hasn't seen this pitcher yet. Oh, sorry, one ball, one strike. Counts even. It's come full of crap. That ball's down and away. My producer and the director of events are both agreeing with the fact that I am full of crap. Pretty much a consensus here from the SportsCanada.tv team. Don't worry about it. I wouldn't mislead you when it comes to softball, folks. And this is a heck of a game here. We have Canada versus USA. If you've just joined us, where have you been? This is a great game. Ball three. All right. So Ogilvie doing a good job of working the count to her favor. We have a hitter's count here. One runner on, one away. Ogilvie steps in. Let's see if she's able to make solid contact here off Sheridan Hawkins, a Team USA pitcher. Sorry, 2-2. Scoreboard was wrong. Pulls the string. That ball's low. Runs the count to full. U.S. fans didn't agree with that. I think they were hoping for a punch out there. We hear a spattering of boos. Some friendly heckling, maybe not so friendly. Can't really see from here. So here we go, payoff pitch. Probably the biggest at bat for the Canadian squad here. Hawkins gets her to strike out. That's a great pitch. Tied her up in the hands with a rise ball. And there's the second out.
Brings up number 9. Made no bad phone number enough. The second base of DCMB, Aspen Sorrell.
So Aspen Sorrell's up.
His last call at the bar.
Last call for alcohol if you're in the building and watching us on SportsCanada.tv. Not sure why you would be, staring at a screen as opposed to watching the ball game live, because it is one heck of a game. Here the Canada chants start. Aspen Searle's been quiet with a stick so far. If this is really your chance, you know, it's really time to clutch up here if you're a Canadian batter. You've seen Hawkins twice. This is going to be the third time through the lineup. And Searle's really got to be the leader that, well, she's expected to be as that leadoff hitter. Here's the pitch from Hawkins. That ball's down, ball one. So as this game has worn on into the sixth inning and here with two outs, it looks like Hawkins, I wouldn't say she's struggling for control, but she's certainly not as precise as she was early in the game. Maybe Canada's being a little more patient as that ball is hit. Fly ball, bit of a can of corn though, there's the third out. So solid contact made by Aspen Searle, but it was right at the American fielder.
After 5.5 innings of play, the United States 3, Canada 0, bottom of the sixth coming up.
The threat's been averted, so Canada's down to the last three outs.
TVM mouth. To the États-Unis, 3, le Canada 0.
And I don't doubt the U.S. squad is going to be...
Last call for alcohol in the beer tent.
There's the last call. I don't doubt that, you know, right now the U.S. squad's really going to be looking to step on the throat of this Canadian team here, really put them out of their misery. I wouldn't say they're in misery, but the U.S. squad's going to look to end it here. They're going to look to get on the bats and have a bit of an offensive outburst. Start with Kelsey Stewart, designated player. Left-handed bat here
batting
for USA.
USA, number 27. Maintenant, bat pour les États-Unis, numéro 27. The DP is US designé, Kelsey Stewart.
Stewart stands in there. She's been slapping, and she looks to drag bunt that. Good job by the Canadians of avoiding contact with that ball in fair territory. As it was popped up, none of them could get to it, and it hopped into foul. So strike one against Hawkins. No, this is Stewart, sorry. Odds were 2-9 that I was going to get a Hawkins right. So here's the pitch. That one's in the dirt, ball one. Sarah Groenwagen having a heck of a game here on the hill for Team Canada. But she gets a... Oops. 2-2 the count now. Little bit of a mental lapse there by Riley Carter, the catcher, as she thought it was strike three and threw down to third base. Brings the count to 2-2. Groenwagen. There's a delivery from her. Stewart fouls it off. Count remains 2-2 with no one out here in the bottom half of the sixth inning. As I mentioned, Team USA probably looking to score some runs and maybe end this one early. Certainly one of the harder tests they've had in this tournament so far. As both these teams come into the game undefeated, although Canada has three outs to keep their record unblemished so far at this tournament. Otherwise, it will probably put them into a tie for second place with, I think, New Zealand in the pool. Of course, that'll be a battle tomorrow night as the Kiwis and the Canadians go at it. It looks like we have a bit of a 50-50 draw coming up here. Counts full here to Stewart. Groenwagen, here's the pitch. That ball's lifted into the gap here. Jenner goes back. One hop to the fence. And oh man, can Stewart fly. She's going for third. Here's the throw. Slides in head first, safe. And just like I thought, you know, Team USA is really looking to put the boots to Canada here and maybe get out of this one a little early, go home and go to bed before we get to seven. Kelsey Stewart,
better now, number 26.
Sliding triple.
Make no bats on the middle of 20. The shortstop, Alec Cool, Sierra Romero.
Brings up the number three hitter, Sierra Romero. Romero maybe looking to slap one out there. Great defensive play. Janet Leung makes a heck of a catch and then throws on to third to try and get Stewart sleeping. Ooh, baby, that was a nice catch, though. She was pretty much full extension for that one.
Making all that on the mill. Catch off the third base for the MB, Misha Sadaraka.
You know, the Brampton fans here, they appreciate some good defense. Who wouldn't on a play like that? I wish we had instant replay. We could show it to you again. You know what? We are going to have instant replay. I don't think Leung's getting to that. That's an RBI single for the number four hitter, Misha Sadaraka, the Hawaii native. Kauai's that one out there. That's not funny.
Brings up number two.
I'm sorry for that joke, guys.
The left fielder. Oh, it's Sean's goal.
Possibly the worst joke.
Emily Crane.
But if you're a fan of bad jokes, maybe tweet them to us. At Sports Canada TV. Maybe if you have a not so funny pun, you know, half-hearted one-liner you like to throw out there, just give us a shout out. We'll give you a shout out. At Sports Canada TV. So the lead now 4-0 here. Team Canada's head coach came out to have a little chat with her pitcher. I'm sure it was just a refocus. Let's get out of this inning and let's get on the sticks. Team Canada still within slam range, as I like to call it. And you know, anything can happen, folks. It's Celtic. We have a pinch runner. I guess that's Sierra Lawrence over there, pinch running for Misha Sataraka. Sierra Lawrence from Shellville, Georgia. She plays at Michigan as well. Enrolled at the School of Kinesiology in Michigan. Some of the best people I know are kinesiologists of a sort. Runner goes, there's the throw, beautiful throw from Carter. Got her dead to rights. Two out, folks. Man, that throw was right on the money. Sierra Lawrence was, she got a great jump off that pitch. Of course, runners can't go until the ball leaves the pitcher's hand in softball. So that ball's lifted into center field. Jenner goes back, settles under it, makes the catch. But again, the damage has been done. USA scores for the second time in the game. That time it was just one. Widens their lead to 4-0.
We'll now announce the winner of the 50-50 draw, which is $407. Ooh-wee. Thank you for supporting the Brampton Girls Softball Association. The winning number, 0405647. Again, that's 0405647. Please come see John at the tower.
Now I was just going to give a bit of a shout out to the Michigan program. Obviously, plenty of players that have worn the red, white, and blue for Team USA have come through Coach Hutchins' ranks, and it's certainly one of the elite and most decorated programs in women's softball in the NCAA.
Canada coming to bat in the top of the seventh. Supporters and fans make a little noise.
Après le sixième match, les États-Unis 4, le Canada 0.
As we hear the fans one more time, hopefully it's not the last time. You know, this really is going to be the last chance for romance here for Canada. Down to their last three outs.
Leading off in the top of the seventh inning for Canada is number two.
Maintenant, battant pour le Canada, numéro deux.
The right fielder,
au champ droit,
Tori Charters
comes up, Jackrabbit. She is quick down the line. Look for her to just put the ball in play and try to leg something out. Hopefully she can act as a spark plug for this Canadian defense. As you see her, she's dancing out of that box. Again, she's employing that kind of slap technique. Hoping to maybe drag bunt, just put the ball in play, as I mentioned, and hustle down that line. No balls, one strike to count. Here's the delivery. Cracker of a bunt laid down. Hawkins fields it. Gets her by a half step. Fantastic defense from the pitcher, Hawkins. Man, oh man. This Team USA really is a complete squad.
Brings up number 15.
Make no bat on the mill. Okay.
They do everything on the pitch. Defense, offense, pitching.
Chelsea Jenner.
Chelsea Jenner digs in. Canada's best hitter of the tournament so far. See if she can do something here for Team Canada here. Two outs remaining. Called strike, that one looked a little inside. Jenner looks down to the coach for signs. Really not much you can try and plan for here, maybe a surprise bunt. I don't think that's Jenner's forte though. She has been peppering these gaps with balls. Oh, quick glove there. Fantastic play by Misha Sadikara. Holy smokes.
Brings up
flash
number
that
44.
Glove out with
deadly intent. The pitcher, the lances, Sarah Groenwegen.
So here it is, folks. Canada's down to its last out here in Brampton. Sarah Groenwegen. If anybody in the Canadian lineup you'd want up to put a run on the board, this is the one. She shows bunt. Takes strike one on the outside corner. Didn't pick up the spin on that one, but painted the black on the outer half of the plate there. Groenwegen digs in. No balls, one strike, two gone here, top half of the seventh. Home team USA leading 4-0 over Team Canada in our feature match. Hawkins pulls the string on that one, bounces it in. Ball one, counts even, 1-1. Crowd getting a little restless here in Canada. Here's the pitch from Hawkins. Groenwegen swings through it, another strong spinner. That has been Hawkins' go-to pitch this game, as she has been moving that ball quite well throughout the strike zone of this Canadian squad. One ball, two strikes. Here's the pitch. Hits the batter. And just like that, Team Canada's got a base runner. So, you know, any way possible, right? It's all about that on-base percentage. For those of you that have seen Moneyball or read the book, I'm going to go out on a limb and say Michael Lewis.
Brings up number 23. The designated player. Jordan Beck.
Maybe part of it's just because I didn't buy Brad Pitt as a baseball player, but or a former baseball player. But enough about movies, folks. We're in a ball game here. We got a pinch runner in for Sarah Groenwegen. So we see Chelsea Strandlin in to run for Sarah Groenwegen here. New life here as we have Vancouver BC's Jordan Beck stepping up to the plate. Here's the pitch. Beck takes a strike on the outer half. Like I was saying earlier, Hawkins really throws that rise ball as several different pitches. She throws it high to get Canadian batters to chase. She can throw it even higher as a show pitch. And she can start it at the knees and bring it up across the about thigh high. By the time it reaches the plate, it really is an effective pitch. That ball is crushed, but way foul. Beck was out in front of that changeup. Solid contact made there. And you know, folks, if this is cricket and we're on a 360-degree field, that probably goes for six. But, you know, we're here. Yeah, the Kiwi got my joke. We're here playing on a 90-degree field, and that's just a long, loud strike, folks. Two gone. Two strikes, no balls on the batter. Here's the pitch to Beck. And that's a wild pitch. So the plot thickens. Strandlin goes to second base on the wild pitch. There's a ball in the batter. And Beck stands in looking to cash a run here for Canada. Maybe salvage a score a little bit. And it looks like we have a coach going out there to talk to. The American infield as they gather around pitcher Hawkins. Producers there getting in my way. I don't know if you can hear it. I don't know if our mics are picking it up. We got the Let's Go Canada chant going. This crowd's hungry to see Canada score a run. You know, they haven't been denied up to this point. They're hoping Jordan Beck can come through. As they urge on this Canadian squad here at the Under-19 Women's World Championships from Brampton, Ontario. Here's the pitch. Beck stays alive as she fouls it straight back. Our director of events was jumping out of the way trying to preserve our cameras. We do have a history of taking balls to the camera at sportscanada.tv. And to the head, apparently, as one of our camera operators had one bounce off her cranium earlier. So here it is, one ball, two strikes. Beck, again, she's hanging and banging up there. Working hard to stay alive and salvage something out of this at bat. I don't know about the rest of these Canadian fans, but I'm getting a little nervous. I'll be the first to admit that I'm a bit of a homer. Definitely hoping these Canadian girls can maybe put at least one up on the board here against Team USA. It's just for, you know, prosperity's sake. Here's the pitch. And another long, loud fly ball from Beck. I think she hit that one to Pickering, folks, but it was foul. Well, we're coming up on 20 minutes after 9 Eastern Standard Time. One ball, two strikes, we're gonna do it all again here, folks. Two out, we're in the top half of the seventh. Here it is. And a bit of a fist pump there. You could tell Hawkins wanted that one. She gets Beck to chase the change up in the dirt.
USA,
Beck, that was a great at bat. You couldn't have asked for more from her. We're going to watch the teams give a cheer. I'd just like to thank you all for joining us. Final score of this game, round robin play, 4-0 Team USA. Team Canada only managed one hit in the game. That was in the fifth inning. You know what? Come back tomorrow night. We're going to have a little commentary from our Kiwi American friend. He's going to come by and help me out with the Canada-New Zealand game, which is our feature match tomorrow night at 7:30. Thanks for watching again, guys. Take care. For SportsCanada.tv, I'm Adam Donnelly. I'll see you again.